Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Alice Rita. If you're a new subscriber, you're welcome to my channel. To all my returning subscribers, thank you for supporting this channel. I appreciate your love and support. Please, if you find today's tutorial useful, please click the like button. And if you want me to record more content like this, please subscribe so I can generate more videos. Thank you. In my video today, I'm going to show you how to add Word PDF document to your Word document. In some universities, when you have publications from your PhD degree, you're expected to add the publications to the end of your PhD thesis as an appendix. And here, I have a document I've opened, a PDF document I've opened from one of the publications that I have from my PhD thesis. And I'm going to be showing you how to add this to this Word document that we have merged together in the last video. There are two ways to go about this. The first option is to convert this Word document into a PDF by using an online tool. You can actually use the export function to export your Word document to a PDF. But if you're having a large document like I'm having, the Word document will not allow you to export the document into PDF. What do I mean by this? If you go to File, if you click on Save As, File, Save As, and you choose the PDF option. Where is PDF? And you choose the PDF option and you click that it should export. It's going to return an error that it's unable to do this. And the error that it has given is that the file size is larger than 40 megabytes. So how do you then solve this problem? You can use online PDF converter, which is my own preferred choice. I use this web page to convert mine, which is called PDF Converter. I'm going to be adding the link to this PDF page, to this page, in the description box. And all you have to do is to choose your document. And after you've chosen your document, you click open and it's going to process. So as not to waste our time, I've already done one. And the next thing you just have to do is click download. So when you have your downloaded PDF, you can then decide to add to the end of the section of the page. So let's go to page 293, which is the last page of this thesis. So you can see we have this blank page here. If you have a full license of the Adobe, it's easy for you to add in more pages. So there is an option to insert pages. So all you just have to do is click from File and then choose the PDF, which is the manuscript, and click Select. This is going to, after the last page, click, and this will automatically add the manuscript. This I'm going to delete. Are you sure you want to delete? Yes, I don't want that empty page. So you can see, I've successfully added the manuscript to the end of the dissertation. And this, you can then just save it and close. My PC is making a lot of noise. I'm just going to try and close this now after I've added this together. So that's option number one. Let me quickly open that document again so I can show you why I do not prefer that option to the option I'm going to show you. If you observe, the last document in the thesis is page 292. However, when you merge the documents together, the subsequent pages do not have page number. And this is why I do not prefer the option of merging your thesis with the manuscript. So which other way would I have done this? I'm going to close the Adobe software so that the PC can stop making noise. What I'm going to do is that I'm going to then go to the last page of my thesis Word in the Word document. And the last page here is page 292. And you can see that page 293 is the blank page that we have. So using the same insert method that we used to merge our Word document together, we're going to go to insert. Insert, this time around, we're going to be using the insert object function. But the problem is that if we use the insert objects function, we can't insert all the pages of the manuscript. So if you click insert, it's only going to insert the first page of the manuscript. And pardon me that my screen is showing as black. It's because I love to work on the dark mode, but I'm going to quickly change this for the setting of this recording. I've changed the view of my documents from dark mode to white mode, so you can see the PDF I added. You can see that it only inserted the first page of the manuscript and it has the page number. So how will I solve it that I'm able to add all the several pages of the PDF to the Word document? This, I'm just going to click Ctrl Z and show you the web page I use in splitting the PDF. So I use this split PDF to go. I'm just going to choose the document. That's the manuscript that we have. I think I save it to, yes, here. Open. And it's going to split the PDF into several pages. And just to save time, I'm going to show you, this is it here. After it has finished splitting them, you can see I have the different pages of the manuscript as an individual page, one of one, two of two, up to the end. And then we're then going to then choose each page of the PDF and click insert. So this is going to be from, it's in download, it here. Just choose the first one that says one to one, insert. You can see that we now have the first page with the page number. I'm just going to continue doing that until you've added all the pages. So if you are using Word document, you should be able to highlight everything at once and hard, but with the MacBook, it doesn't allow you to do that. So you see, I've added the second page. I'll just quickly add, let's assume that I'm going to add the third one and then stop there. Text object. So this is going to be page 3 of 3, and that is how you add your PDF to your Word document while still having the page number. So personally, I prefer this option because if someone like is like, oh, could you please go to page 294 of your thesis, you can easily find the 294 rather than the previous one that ended in 292 and then you have pages without number. So please, if you find today's tutorial useful, please like it, share with your friends, and let me know in the comment section which other tutorial you would like me to record in my next video. And until next time, thank you so much. Bye.